My name is James Elder. I'm a professor here at York University. My research is on human and computer vision. So this is very interdisciplinary. And matching that, I'm actually jointly appointed to two departments here at York, the Electrical Engineering and Computer Science Department, which is part of the LaSalle School of Engineering, and the Department of Psychology. I first got started in research with a fascination in the human brain. So I was particularly interested in human perception and how it is that we're able to perceive our environment, navigate easily, recognize objects without even really thinking about it. And I became particularly interested in this as a computational problem. So this has led me to a joint study of computation, mathematics, and also neuroscience. One of the projects I'm most proud of is our work on attentive sensing. So this really originated with an interest in how the human visual system works attentively. So we survive by having very wide field of view vision, but also the ability to see fine detail when we point our eyes at something. And to make this work effectively, we have to be able to move our eyes very quickly. So we have this very well-developed visuomotor system. That really hasn't been seen in computer vision so much to date. And so what we developed was an artificial visual system that had these properties. By combining two different kinds of cameras, we were able to obtain a large field of view, but high resolution at points of interest. I'm proud of this, partly because, you know, it's a good example of how something starts with an interest in biological systems and ends up in some very interesting technology, which we've now patented. And also because I think there's just a lot of applications which could really benefit. So these include security, remote learning, teleconferencing, sports videography, and we've been exploring a lot of these applications. You know, if you come into my lab today, you'll see a real mixture of students and postdoctoral fellows from electrical engineering, computer science, mathematics, and psychology. And so there really is a mixture of these skills and training that I think is crucial for understanding these problems. The company we've been working with is Autodesk Research, also here in Toronto. So they are really the leading manufacturers, designers of 3D modeling software. So they have incredible experience in how to build or tools to build large-scale 3D models, and how these 3D models can be used effectively for just a huge diversity of applications. So they are getting more and more interested in how do we combine these rich 3D models with human activity to better optimize how buildings and other things are used. So this is a perfect match to our own research, where we are working on sensing and modeling of human dynamics in urban environments. In the last few years, we've seen the emergence of really rich, democratically available 3D geodatabases. At the same time, we have this very rich infrastructure of real-time sensing, so for example, video cameras. So on the one hand, we have 3D geodatabases, which are three-dimensional but static. On the other hand, we have 2D video data, which is only two-dimensional, but it's dynamic. So the obvious and big opportunity is to try to fuse these two to have an integrated system that delivers information that's both three-dimensional and dynamic. Now, at the same time, we have a lot of problems, I think, in our cities that we need to solve. So, for example, we have a lot of transit problems, and we have safety problems, and also carbon footprint. We have a lot of impact on the environment. What's key, I think, is to understand that humans are best at understanding information when presented in a naturalistic three-dimensional context.